Okay, so I'm gonna do a review of a movie I saw called Ghost in the Shell. Fucking good movie. Very confusing, but kind of hard to understand a little bit, but I think it's good. So I'm gonna read the synopsis thing from the movie, and then I'll go in my own words so you guys get more of an idea from the visual thingamabobber. Okay, so Majum Motoko Kusanagi, a female cyborg and leader of Section 9's assault team, is assigned to capture an elusive hacker known as the Puppet Master. Her team Batu and Ishikawa triangulates his activity to a garbage man. He believes he is going through a divorce, and he thinks he's using a program from a sympathetic man to illegally ghost hack his wife's mind to find his daughter. So basically, this guy who's a garbage man, he told this guy this this one man his story in a bar, and the man felt sorry for him. Because he said he can't see his daughter anymore, so he said how he could ghost hack his wife's mind to let him see his daughter, and so she won't be a bitch. So that's the essential ness of it. Kusanagi and her team arrest both the garbage man and the man who gave him the program, but they discover both men's memories were either erased or implanted, and so they were basically brainwashed, essentially. Telepathically or through ghost hacking, by the Puppet Master, who is that's who Motoko is going after. And so after they do that, they a hacker hacks into a facility and orders to assemble a female cybernetic body. The body escapes but is struck by a truck. Section 9 gets the body to investigate. They find that the body is completely robotic. Seems that the human ghost within it, perhaps the human puppet master himself, suit officials from Section 6 visit Section 9 and explain to them that the body was constructed to lure the puppet master's ghost into it and trap the ghost inside. Kusanagi spies a conversation and wants to dive into the body to contact the Puppet Master's ghost. But before she can do so, the ghost activates the body. Section 6 then storms Section 9 and takes the body away. The information obtained from the body leads Section 9 to uncover mysterious Project 2501. So 2501 is basically, it is a not artificial intelligence, but an intelligent life form. It's it is what's it called? It's an intelligent life form, and it basically controls itself, and it like hacks the system so it can override everything. So basically, it blows up the lab and escapes, essentially. So then Motoko and I believe his name's Nato. Let me check. So, I believe his name's Nato, and he and Kusanagi go and try to get the puppet master, but they're thwarted by a spider tank, and it gets so close to killing her, and Nato has a big ass gun that's like a super powered rocket launcher. It's just like it's crazy. And then so that's the spider tank, and then they find the 2501, and 2501 wants to Kusanagi wants to ghost hack into the N2501 and communicate and stuff. So, yeah. So the sound, the music, it all goes very atmospherically with it. It's very good. All just really pretty awesome. Yes? Hi. You need to stop being so loud. And then, but the music, the sound, the songs are just really great. It's just really very powerful mood setting. The voice acting is great. It does some pretty crazy stuff that happens. It's not like gory, really. There's a bit of violence, but overall, the movie's pretty damn good. I enjoyed it. Thanks to my friend Andy. Got to find out it existed and check it out. What are you doing? So that's it. That's Ghost in the Shell review. Basically, it's awesome. In case anyone didn't know, it's an anime movie, so yeah. If you don't like anime, then don't watch it. But it's good. So that's it. So bye!